Hello WordPress enthusiasts and welcome to a new episode about SEO. I think this is my first video on this channel about search engine optimization, even though I have been using this strategy for a long time on my blogs. My name is Robert, and in this video I will show you how to prepare your blog posts for success in 2020. This is the exact step-by-step method I use as WordPress SEO to increase the chance of getting free and targeted traffic. One more thing before moving on is to make sure you subscribe to this channel and ring the bell to get notified when future videos will be published. Are you using any keyword research tool for inspiration and search engine optimization? Put this video on pause, leave a comment below with your preferred tool, and then come back to discover the tool I use almost every day, not only for my blog posts, but for everything I create online. AnswerThePublic.com is great for both keyword research and content strategy, and you can use it a couple of times per day for free. The blog article I want to put together in this video is a list of best cool gadgets you can buy in 2020. I made this blog a year ago or so, for showing you how to buy a domain name and hosting, and how to create a WordPress blog, but I never thought I would use it. Then I saw a video on YouTube about AnswerThePublic.com, and I got the idea to try the cool gadgets keyword and see how it goes. Honestly, I was amazed. As you can see in the results over here, I got a bunch of questions, prepositions, comparisons, alphabetical and also related keywords for cool gadgets. If I go directly to the related searches, I can see that I have 20 results, which are probably the best main keywords that I should use in my article. I think I can pick cool gadgets for 2020 as the main keyword and further optimize my blog post around this one. I guess it might be a very competitive niche, but you can use the same technique to discover niches without too much competition. Optimizing your article around long-tail keywords like cool gadgets on Amazon under 10 or 25 could help ranking higher and faster in search engines like Google or Bing, I guess. The first thing I recommend to do before picking your main keyword is trying a search on Google, for example, and see how much competition there is. If I go incognito and try searching for cool gadgets 2020, I get even more keyword suggestions, which are search terms people use often. Using an incognito window will help you get clean suggestions that are not affected by your browsing or search history. To go incognito on Chrome, push Ctrl plus Shift plus N on your keyboard, or simply click the three dots in the top right corner of your browser, then pick the new incognito window. I can copy every keyword below and optimize my article around them. You can use tools like Trello.com to organize your content strategy, and go from idea to published content as I do on this channel. Newest, unique, tech, kitchen, and so on are words I would definitely use in my article. As you may notice, I want my WordPress blog to rank for multiple keywords, not just one. As a beginner, I made the mistake to optimize my blog posts only for one or maybe two keywords. Now I understand that Google, as well as Bing, can rank my blog post not just for 1, 2, 10, but for hundreds of keywords related to the same subject. LSI keywords are synonyms and variations of your main keyword, which may be in the form of a phrase or word, and these words are useful. So, I got the main keyword and the full list of other related keywords, as well as some long-tail keywords with significant searches as you can see in the keyword research tool near each phrase. To see the average monthly searches near each keyword, you need to install the Keywords Everywhere Chrome extension, which is a paid tool that's worth every penny. Now that I have the list of keywords, I can go ahead to the next step, which is to install an SEO plugin. I prefer UOS SEO, but you can go with Rank Math, as well as all-in-one SEO for WordPress. I want to keep this video as short as possible, so I won't go deep into the UOS settings. Just install and activate the plugin for now, and you are good to go. It will give you some good hints at the bottom of each article after adding the target keyword in this field. Before anything else, make sure your permalink structure is SEO friendly. To do that, go to the permalink settings on your dashboard and make sure the structure is set as post name. This way, you get beautiful links like this, and search engines will love them. Now I can go ahead and add a new post named Unique and Cool New Gadgets You Can Buy in 2020 for Your Kitchen. And this is just an example. I think you can pick something more catchy. I guess it's a great title, because it is filled with many of those suggested search variations on Google. Then I can move to the next step, which is to create the structure of my blog post. Before moving on, a very important thing is to edit the permalink above and use the main keyword here instead of the full title, which is created automatically after you hit save or publish. I just type in Cool Gadgets 2020 over here, exactly as I write a simple text, with spaces between words. Don't worry about dashes, they will be added automatically once you hit save. I recommend doing it for every article on your blog. It is a very important SEO step. Now I will start writing the content and add my keywords as H2 and H3 titles below. Fast forward, this is how the structure of my article looks like when finished adding each title and subtitle. Then you can start writing 2 or 3 short sentences about each product or category. You can get inspiration from the product page on Amazon, for example, but keep the description as short as possible. At the end of each product review, you can insert a button like this and say buy it now on Amazon, but this is for monetizing your blog and not an SEO optimization. For SEO, I would recommend adding and optimizing images after every 3 lines of text. You can do it after 4 or more, but for better visual experience, your blog post should look like this. And keep in mind that your visitors will navigate on your blog mainly from mobile devices. The checklist for optimized images is this. Make sure you are using the keyword in the file name. Set the alt text, like so, and I think you can add a text below the image, which could include the keyword, but make sure you don't push it with too many keywords. You can put your affiliate link as a hyperlink over here, which should open in a new window. This way, people will come back to your blog automatically when closing that page. This is it for image optimization. Maybe you can do one more thing, which is to speed up your website, and that is to use an image optimization plugin or service like Optimoli, which can add lazy loading to your images and reduce the size without losing quality. Now that my article is finished and ready to publish, I need to make sure I add some internal links. I can say something like, check out other cool gadgets for your home and link this portion of the text to that blog post. Then I would like to check out carefully the entire blog post from top to bottom and publish it. Another great piece of content is live on the web now. These were all on-page SEO techniques, but there are hundreds of other things you should do to rank your blog in search engines. A piece of a good advice I get from SEO and marketing experts like Brian from Backlinko and Neil Patel is to make sure you write original and quality content. Check out other videos on our channel and make sure you subscribe, then ring the bell to get notified when new videos are published. Keep up the good work and see you in the next video. Cheers!